Welcome to the fifth session of the chapter Microbes in Human Welfare. In this module, we are going to learn about the role of microbes in the production of biogas. We know biogas is a mixture of gases and it is produced by microbial activity. And this gas can be used for various purposes like lighting and cooking. As I told, it is produced by microbial activity, and these bacteria, there is a microbes which is used as bacteria. These bacteria are strictly anaerobic. Anaerobic means they grow in conditions or in the absence of oxygen. They grow anaerobically on cellulosic material, that is, they digest cellulosic material and grow, and they produce large amount of methane along with carbon dioxide and hydrogen. So biogas is a mixture of gases, namely methane, carbon dioxide and hydrogen. The bacteria which helps in this production of biogas are called as methanogens or methanogenic bacteria. We have studied this methanogenic anaerobic bacteria in the anaerobic sludge digester in the STPs, which again in the sludge digester it produces large amount of gases like biogas. And this bacteria, it is also present in the rumen of cattle. Rumen means it is a part of the alimentary canal of ruminant animals, and the food that such cattle eat is having large amount of cellulosic material, and it is reaching the rumen. Once it reaches the rumen, this bacteria which is present in the rumen, it helps in the breakdown of the cellulose, and thus it plays a very important role in the nutrition of cattle because it is helping in the breakdown of cellulose. Okay, and after that, the excretory product, that is the dung of cattle, which is commonly called as gober, and this gober or dung is much rich in this methanogenic bacteria, and this dung is used for the generation of biogas, and the alternative name for biogas is gober gas. Why the dung is used? Because the dung has a large amount of methanogenic bacteria. The technology of biogas production in India was a joint effort by IARI, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, and Khadi and Village Industries Commission, KVIC, and their joint effort initiated the technology of biogas production in the rural areas in India. In this biogas plant, the structure of a biogas plant, it consists of a concrete tank which is about 10 to 15 feet deep, and this is a picture of a biogas plant, and this is the concrete tank which is about 10 to 15 feet deep, which has an inlet. Through the inlet, the slurry is fed. The slurry consists of bio waste, dung and water. Bio waste can be agriculture waste, sewage, manure, food waste, kitchen waste. Everything is mixed up with dung and water and is fed in through the inlet. And this digester or the concrete tank is covered by a floating lid. Why a floating lid? Why it is not fixed? Because as the dung which is having the methanogenic bacteria, it starts to break down the bio waste or the cellulosic waste, it starts to produce biogas. And as the amount of biogas in the digester increases, the lid will start to rise up. It will start to rise up. And this is a gas holder which holds a biogas, which is a combination of mixture of gases like methane, carbon dioxide and hydrogen. And from this gas holder, there is an outlet. Through the outlet, the gas is taken out and connected to pipelines, and the pipelines are fitted to nearby houses so that the houses can use this biogas for cooking and lighting purpose. Once the slurry is completely utilized, the leftover slurry or the spent slurry is used as a fertilizer. It can substitute fertilizers, or it is very helpful to increase the fertility of soil in agricultural fields. In this module, we have learned about the role of microbes in biogas production. Biogas is an alternative gas and is produced with the help of microbes, namely methanogenic bacteria.